Topic of today's seminar is functional independence measure. So objectives: at the end of the seminar, students will be able to understand what is functional independence measure, domains of functional independence measure, interpretation of the scale, validity and reliability of the scale, and recent advances related to the scale. Introduction. So the functional independence measure, it is an instrument that was developed as a measure of disability for a variety of populations, and it is not specific to any diagnosis. So the FIM was developed between 1984 and 1987 by National Task Force sponsored by American Academy of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation and American Congress of Rehabilitation Medicine. It was published by Keith Granger Hamilton in the year 1987. It includes measures of independence, which are self-care, including sphincter control, transfers, locomotion, communication, and social cognition. It is an 18-item, 7-level ordinal scale intended to be sensitive to changes over the course of comprehensive inpatient medical rehabilitation program. The tool was used to assess a patient's level of disability as well as change in patient status in response to rehabilitation or medical intervention. So the domains of functional independence measure. It has two main domains, motor domain and cognitive domain. The motor domain has 13 items, while the cognitive domain has 5 items. The motor domain includes self-care, which has 16 items, sphincter control, 2 items, transfer, 3 items, locomotion, 2 items. While the cognitive domain, which has 5 items, it includes first, communication, which has 2 items, and social cognition, which has 3 items. So the intended population, it was designed to assess areas of dysfunction in activities that commonly occur in subjects with any progressive, reversible, or stable neurological, musculoskeletal, or other disorders that are patient with functional mobility impairments. So the FIM is used for healthcare practitioners to assess and grade the functional status of person based on level of assistance he or she requires. It is used in elderly individuals undergoing inpatient rehabilitation and has been used with children as young as 7 years old. The scoring. So each item of the FIM is scored upon a 7-point Likert scale, and the score indicates the amount of assistance required to perform in each item. So if the score is 1, it indicates total assistance in all areas, and if the score is 7, it indicates total independence in all areas. The ratings are based on performance rather than capacity and can be acquired by observation, patient interview, and telephone interview, or even medical records. So the developers of the FIM recommend that the scoring be derived by conscious with a multidisciplinary team. So the final summed score is created, and it ranges from 18 to 126, where 18 represents complete dependence or total assistance, and 126 represents complete independence. So there are different levels in the functional independence measure. So the first is no helper. In that, the first is complete dependence. It includes timely and safety. This other one is modified independence, which includes device. The second level is helper modified dependence. It includes supervision, that is 100% supervision, minimal assistance, that is 75% or more, or moderate assistance, that is 50% or more. So the third level is helpers complete dependence. The first one included is maximal assistance, and the second one included is total assistance or not testable. Okay, so the total score of the FIM. The motor subscale, it includes the sum of the individual's motor subscale item, will be the value between 13 and 91, and the cognition subscale, it will include the sum of the individual's cognition subscale items, which will be the values between 5 and 35. The total score of the FIM instrument will be the value between 18 and 126. So the validity and reliability of the scale. The inter-rater reliability of functional independence measure has been established at an acceptable psychometric performance, that is, the inter-class correlation coefficients ranging from 0.86 to 0.88. The concurrent validity of Barthel index, ICC greater than 0.83, have shown strong construct validity between items on Barthel index and items on the FIM of the measure functional limitation. So, literature. The physiotherapy needs assessment of people with stroke following discharge from hospital stratified by acute functional independence measure score. The study was done by Vincent DePaul et al. So the purpose was to determine the physiotherapy related needs of the people with stroke at discharge. 6 months after discharge and 1 year after discharge from hospital, and to examine the results stratified by participants' acute functional independence measure scores. So the conclusion of the study was, over the first year of after discharge from hospital, people with stroke report a large and varied number of persistent mobility related needs, and physiotherapists have a role to play in advocating the advocate follow-up services and informing health policies with respect to the needs of their patient with stroke. So the other study was to see the relationship between functional independence measure score on admission and influence of the inhibitor factors in comprehensive inpatient stroke rehabilitation ward. The study was done by Sayaka Okamoto et al. The objective of the study was to investigate how the influence of inhibitor factors was changed by status of activities of daily living. So the results showed that FIM motor subscale at discharge and the FIM motor subscale at gain were significantly low in patients with decreased trunk function and low ADL score on admission. Both were significantly low in patients with relatively wide ranged ADL scores in elderly patients whose age was above 68 years or older, and also significantly low in cognitive function patients who needed moderate or severe assistance. So the conclusion of this study was, these results demonstrated that influence of inhibitor factors is not uniform, but instead differs according to the degree of ADL level of admission. So these are the references.